Hello, I'm Sensei Alex Kikuyu, North American correspondent for Buddhist Door Global. Thanks for joining me for this episode of The Ordinary Buddhist. The title of today's talk is Learning to Take Refuge. Before we get into that, please subscribe and hit the notification bell. That way you'll be notified when I post talks in the future. If you wouldn't mind hitting the like button, that'd be great too. As snow continues to fall, one thing I've noticed is that my relationship with the snow changes depending on my location. If there's a blizzard outside and I'm doing some work outdoors, tending to the animals or repairing a fence, then the snow can be a cause of suffering. However, if I take refuge here at the homestead and I'm looking at the snow from the safety of a window, preferably with a hot cup of tea in my hand, the snow can be quite beautiful. Outside, the snow is suffering. Inside, the snow is beautiful. This is true of the weather, but it's also true of the world in general. This is why in Buddhism we take refuge in the Buddha, the Dharma, and the Sangha. In other words, we strive to emulate the example set by the historical Buddha. We learn his teachings by studying the Dharma as found in the Buddhist scriptures, and we strive to build relationships with the larger Buddhist community, the Sangha. We do this because the three jewels of Buddha, Dharma, and Sangha are like a spiritual home that protects us from the snow, or the suffering, of the outside world. The chaos of life can be dangerous and painful if we are outside the three jewels, but within them, sometimes it can be humorous, and if it's not humorous, at least it doesn't hurt quite so badly. By remembering to take refuge in the Buddha, the Dharma, and the Sangha, we give ourselves the tools to end suffering not just for ourselves, but for all sentient beings. Amitabha.